So, sir, I am going to talk only on the perspective in the renewables on thermal. So, enough has been talked and discussed on PV, though I am a PV guy, but as the policy we wanted to try for the last 5 years, so we were associating the Japanese universities. So, 5 years back, we started a project that how to use the solar thermal energy, which is more than 75% in the sun. And when we convert to PV, it is only 25% of that we use. So RGPV University from Bhopal and Tokyo Tech University from Japan and my company and MNRE, all the four with 10 crores project, Professor Tamura-san from Japan, he simulated that if we can make a cross-linear CSP, means tower and CSP technology, if we cross it, then the height of the tower will be low, and with this innovation, we can save the almost two-thirds of the space, and we wanted to prove that the temperature up to 600 degrees centigrade can be achieved of the steam, and which can be used for producing the electricity from thermal plants. So this project is near completion, and the Professor Tamura-san stayed here for 2 years, and we could prove, it was a 30 kilowatt, just a project to prove that we can attain this temperature. And the skin temperature was around 850, and the temperature which we could measure was between 450 to 550 degrees centigrade. And more improvements are going. But what was this new perspective was that instead of making a thermal plant in the desert with solar thermal energy, why we don't hybrid it with the existing thermal plants or with the new thermal plants, that we make the steam at a temperature of 550 or 500 and put in the superheater, and during daytime, 3 to 4 or 5 hours of coal consumption can be reduced. So this is the purpose, and now 1 megawatt electrical and 4 megawatt of thermal. That pilot project we have already got designed, and there is a Toyo engineering company from Japan has also got associated. They are the piping company and a big design and EPC company. So they are also the now partners. If we are successful, then this can be one big breakthrough that solar thermal energy can be used, and the space in the thermal plants can be utilized to make the steams, and when the sun is setting in, at that time the hot waters can be used to put in the boiler. So we need not to store the thermal energy, which is a costly affair, but this can be clubbed. So this efforts for the last 5 years with my company and two universities and MNRE ministry, that has been quite successful. So what is, you know, my take is, that when we will say 30 kilowatt and 10 crores project, at that time so many eyebrows were raised from the government side. Oh, this means 10 crores divided by 30 kilowatt, so you are spending almost 100 crores per megawatt. What is this, all that? But in innovation, you have to do so many things. 5 times the heliostats mirrors were changed, and many times we have to engage more people also. But this innovation is successful, I am very happy to say. Secondly, in thermal, we can use all the textile industries can be made also to use the steam, because in the bleaching or in the textiles, in fibers, a lot of steam is used. Third is, my one other experiment is on hydroponics. I am working on solar for agriculture, and we want to save the life of the farmers. My aim is how we can convert each farmer as an industrialist. So plant grows with the sun. If I can create also the light during the night with LEDs and have the power stored in the batteries, then you can have hydroponics where you are growing, you know, the plants during day and night, and my vegetables or strawberries, they can have in the half of the time. So this means a farmer can have double the crops, plus he can have many stages, you know, 10 stages in the same building or at 1 acre, he can have equivalent to 10 acres, and LED can be used, solar energy can be utilized. So this is a new perspective where 1 acre land is equivalent to 20 acres, and farmer can be saved, And this means engineering, technology, as well as young peoples and the farmers all should come together. And with this perspective, we can make it that suicidal tendency in the farmers will go away and we can give a new confidence. This is my perspective of the renewables for the farmers of India. Thank you.